recently read Leadership Theories and Practice by Peter Northhaus. And I really enjoy this book. It's academic based, but what I like about it is that it talks about all the different theories of leadership. I don't think there's one right way to be a leader. And I think it's important that people sort of evolve and discover their own leadership style. And once you understand all the different theories, which this book does a great job of breaking it down, you can sort of select the different things that you think make a great leader and sort of piece that together for yourself.
Brené Brown is actually my favorite leadership author, and she doesn't only do leadership. I don't have a lot of time to read, but one of the books I'm reading of hers right now actually is Dare to Lead. It's really about daring to be authentic, to be courageous and brave in the decisions you make, to be empathetic and to show, you know, vulnerability, which is something you're told not to do, I think, as a leader. So I've just really been inspired by that book in particular right now, and all of her writings in general, which I think follow that same vein.
This is called 21 Irrefutable Laws of Leadership, and John Maxwell is the author. It's one of those books that I usually go back to and, you know, trying to pick up things and refine, you know, what I do. And leadership, you know, to me, isn't something that you can grow overnight. You know, it's something that you have to train for. It's something that you practice every day. And you know, if you take someone like a Michael Phelps, you know, who's an Olympic swimmer, he has a natural talent, but he still needed to be in the pool every day, you know, day in, day out, in order to be an accomplished Olympic swimmer.
There are quite a few leadership books that I enjoy. My favorite one is by Daniel Coleman. It's called Emotional Intelligence. I really believe that strong leaders are ones that are in tune to their feelings. They have that high emotional intelligence, and that helps them to lead teams a little more effectively and efficiently. It's about serving the people on the team that you work for, helping them to be their best selves, helping them to grow and develop. So when they leave, they're a bit stronger and better from a career perspective and personally as well than when they interacted with you. So that's why I believe.
My favorite book on leadership is Lean In by Sheryl Sandberg. I think what I like is more or less the underlying message that as a woman, you can create the life you want. But she approaches the subject by getting to the root cause of what it feels like and might limit a lot of women in their careers. A lot of it comes down to fear. Fear of being judged by coworkers, fear of negative attention, fear of going outside of what society has traditionally decided was appropriate behavior for women. The book really highlighted for me what you can accomplish if you can get beyond the apprehension of other people's perceptions of women.